Hey guys, welcome to the Testing Academy. My name is Pramod and welcome to the series of Cypress tutorial for beginners. And in this video of number 5, we are gonna talk about how to test a REST API with Cypress. All right, so let's get started. So guys, in this video, we are gonna talk about how to test different kind of HTTP methods like get, put, post, patch request, right? These are the common you can say certain HTTP methods which are commonly available whenever we are dealing with REST APIs, right? So I'm going to talk about and will give you a demo how to basically create these kind of requests with Cypress and how you can test them. So if you have a small or any kind of a REST API that you wanted to test it out, but you can use these examples and create your own basically REST API framework which will basically use a Cypress, right? So why we are doing is why we are using REST API, especially REST API testing with Cypress, because it's fast, reliable, and you can say that with minimum code you can basically do most of the things that you want already, right? So let's first of all what you need to do is that you need to have a Node.js installed on your machine, right? So make sure you go Node.js installed. If you haven't installed, go to nodejs.org and download it. So let me show you. So if you haven't installed it, just go to nodejs.org, right, and install it from there, right? And you have a download version, right? So now you need to install Cypress, and we are basically using a Visual Studio in this, right? So these are the nodes that I have already created for you. So first of all, these things I have already like. So what you can do is that you can just create a new directory. So just go to your terminal, right? If you're using a Mac or if you're using a Windows, just go to cmd, right? What you can do is that go to just your documentary. So I mostly do in notework, make directory and REST API testing. You can just create a new directory and just cd into that. Sorry. Yeah. So now what you need to do is that you need to basically create a node project. So how do you create a node project? You just type npm init, and I'm going to pass y so that by default values are getting populated, right? All right. So let's move to that folder first. Right here, so it will automatically create a package JSON, right? Now what you need to do is that you need to install Cypress dependency, right? So when you install that dependency, there will be a new folder which is node underscore modules which will basically get installed. And after that, you can type npx cypress open, which is basically gives a structured view of your Cypress project, right? So let me show you how it looks like. So when you open it in your any kind of text editor, right now I'm using Visual Studio Code. So you will have a Cypress folder, node modules, your Cypress JSON, your package file, right? So what you need to do is that after that, you can basically create certain configurations or give a base URL here. So we are basically using HTTP bin. So HTTP bin basically provides you different kind of methods, basically allows you to basically you can say create certain post requests, put requests, because these are the requests which you cannot make directly from browsers, right? You have to use certain tools. For example, you can use Postman tool, right? So if you have if you want to watch more tutorials related to Postman, I have other full series of Postman covered how to do API testing using Postman. So you can use Postman, right? So now we are basically going to test these kind of all these methods, right? So let's come here. So all the test cases that you generally write in integrations, right? So in REST, in the REST folder, I have created a dummy file, which is basically an empty file. And I have already created a sample for you already. So let's create step by step so that you can understand. So let's create the first thing, which is describe logs, right? So let's say CRUD, not CRUD, basically let's say HTTP example, right? Okay, and we're gonna pass a function, right? And after that, basically, I try basically use most of the time, you can say a semicolon, but you can avoid it because that is totally optional in JavaScript. So this is a get method request, right? So how basically how you can make a request is using the request method, right? Request, and here you will basically tell what is the method that you want, right? It's basically takes a, you can say, kind of a JSON, which basically tells it's a get request. Now you can give the URL. So it's let's get the URL. So the URL for get request, URL for get request is in, it looks like this, get, right? And you can basically use headers, right? And this headers will contain a key value pair, but right now we are not using because get request doesn't basically we don't need much of these in get request especially. So let's pass a function, and here you will have a response, right? Now what you can do is that you can basically write certain assertions here. So expect response dot body basically to now what you can do is that there's an assertion method. Let me open it. Yeah, so Cypress has lots of assertions. It's basically inherit most of these assertions from chai, right? So you can have deep equal to basically checking the JSONs, nesteds, order by, and lots of. So we are going to use this simple one basically. So response.body, so let's do this thing, like response.body, and we can basically use have, right? So have property is also there, right? Have property, yeah. So let's have it here, have property, and let's pass it, basically we are checking the URL property. So let me show you how it looks like, okay? So let's go to this URL, okay, open. When you open this get request, because get request can be open directly into your browser, right? So this is the property, that URL property we are getting, right? So here we are validating basically that this is available, okay? So if you open the Cypress, basically use the Cypress, this command, which one, this one. So npx cypress open, basically this will open this UI tool, and this is your file right now. Okay, so let me stop the previous test. So demo test, let's click on this, okay? And as you can see, it's basically starts making a request, and we have assertion passed. So it basically means that we have successfully created a get request, and also our assertion is also passing, right? So now what you can do is that let me show you for put request, for post request. I want to make a post request. So let's this is just a description, right? So this is a description, but here you need to mention the post request. Here the URL is post, and now interesting thing is that you need to pass any kind of property whenever you are making any kind of you need to pass a JSON, right? The body of your post request. So let's pass a body containing Pramod, and let's say age equal to 27. Okay, now another thing that you can do is that you can basically use headers option also. It is again same type. You can say, let me copy the headers. So headers, we are basically using certain kinds of even say JSON. So we are basically using basically mentioning that we want the response in a JSON format, right? So we can mention that here. Now this response.body, so let's make this request first in Postman. So okay, so let's come here, create a new request, create a post request, and we are passing this JSON, right? So let's go to body raw, let's change it to JSON, right? Let's pass this and see. So it's making a request, right? And you can see, okay, so there's a particular error, right? So let's see what is this error. Okay, we should have double quotes here, right? This is a JSON. Okay. So age is a number, right? So let's make it 27 and draw, right? So when you make this request, is basically whenever you make a post request, right, we want to create something, you want to basically tell the server this is the JSON request, JSON body that I'm passing, right? So it basically spit out all the things. So this is basically spitting out the JSON is there, right? So let's verify that this have a property of JSON. And again, here we can have equal, right? Basically, we can use two deep equal. And now deep equal basically takes a JSON. What is your JSON that you want to verify? This is our JSON, right? So this one I can pass it here. But let's change this with single quotes, because most of the things right now we are working as a single quotes in this one, right? So this is the little bit of difference, but yeah, I hope you get the point, right? And let's make it like this. Let's little bit do it there. So when you save it automatically, it will basically do a request, right? So it's basically saying that to deep equal, it's not actually doing it. So basically we have a failing test. So let's do one thing, because let's make it like this and see. Right, so JSON object is there, but we have deep issues with deep, right? So let's see how we can figure it out. And so basically we are passing Pramod and JSON, right? Okay, so we need to pass it like this. Now it will pass. Both should be number, right? So deep equals are not basically passing in this case. Okay, we have objects to, basically deep equal is still not passing. Okay, let me check with simple request that I have already made. So name Pramod and Pramod, okay, everything is passing here. So let me check if this works, and if it doesn't, let's check with another ones. Okay, it's basically, yeah, let me check it out again. Okay. Okay, so let me check it out. All right, so what was missing is that basically we were not checking with, we are basically checking with the body, right? But it's JSON, right? So we have actually this is the body and we have JSON, and after that we are basically checking with the DB code, right? So that's why it was not just basically getting passed. So now if you see that it basically passed, and we have basically everything is ready, right? So similarly, what you can do, let me open up this one. Similarly, you can do the put request and patch request similar way, that because if you know how to run a post request, most of the things are similar. You just need to change the method name and your headers if you required, right? So you can change that. Okay, so I'll put all the source code and all in the description of this video. Okay, so I hope you have learned how to basically perform a REST API testing with Cypress, right? So few things that you need to still learn is that you should note down this assertion, because while you are writing the test cases of these APIs, you need to know all kind of assertion that basically you are going to make after you receive a response, right? So you can use that. Similarly, if you want to pass any kind of authorization, then definitely you can do that in your headers. You need to mention everything. If it is a basic auth, you can use authorization colon and some similar to this. If it is an auth, you need to pass a token, or to again secret, client ID and secret that you can pass, right? So that was a tutorial. about REST API testing with Cypress, and I hope you get the point. And this was purely practical example, and I'll see you in the next video. And do let me know if you have any kind of issues or any kind of a question in the comments. Okay, I will be happy to help you. Right, don't forget to like, share and comment on these videos, and see you in the next video. Bye.